Hi y'all, welcome to my channel, where I try stuff myself and share my thought, whether if it's EV, tech, gadgets and others. I was talking to a few friends the other day. They were talking about how many cables they had to take for their gadgets and devices. So I'd like to share the review of one accessory that I use when I'm traveling. Well, if we are still doing that these days, it's called InCharge X. I got it from Indiegogo, and right now the project is already in demand. This review is not sponsored by them, it is all my opinion, based on the real test. I'll put the link in the description in case y'all are interested. So let's begin. InCharge X is the fifth and the latest generation of charging cable from the company called Rolling Square. There are two versions of InCharge X, the standard key ring version and the max version, which is 1.5 meters in length. From the campaign's page, the interesting features for this tiny cable are: one, and is rated for up to 100 watt power delivery, so it will work with laptops, MacBooks and others that support PD protocol up to 100 watt. Two, it comes with all types of connector built in at the tip, so you can have six types of cables in one. Three, it is portable as you can put it with the key ring of yours. This is one of the most minimally and environmentally friendly package I have seen, but hey, it's good for environment. Just recycled paper box with logo and short descriptions. Designed in Switzerland and made in China. The build quality overall is pretty good. It comes with adapters at the tip of both sides. If you take these off, you'll see that both ends are USB-C connector. That explains 100 watt power delivery feature. And on the adapter side, it is USB-A at one side and combo micro USB and lighting at the other side. With this, like I said, 3 × 2 = 6. Six types of cables you have, but only to carry one. Pretty cool. It also comes with strong magnet at the tips and protective cap. The max version is the same as the standard version, only longer at 1.5 meters. There are many colors to choose from: sapphire blue, lava black, and marble beige. And I also opt for special color they offer for backers, the green dragon, as y'all see here in the unboxing. To attach to the key ring, just simply remove the cap, separate the tips and feed the cable through the key ring, then snap the magnet closed and put the protective cap back on. Though the max version might not be suitable for the key ring, the built-in magnet comes quite handy to snap on any metal surface. It works as cable organizer in a way. Now let's do some tests to see if it is as good as advertised. Keep in mind that the 100 watt feature is only when you use USB-C to USB-C per their spec sheet. I will use my power meter to monitor the wattage. To reach the max charging speed for each device, you need to have right charging protocol from the charger, and the battery level is at low state of charge, that's 15 to 20%. Let's start with my iPhone 12 mini and the stock cable out of the box. We don't have charger comes with phone nowadays. You can see that with the original cable, it is charging at around 14 watt. Now let's see InCharge X. Consistent result at around 14 watt as well. So is the max version. Now let's test the PD protocol. Both of my Super Tank can be charged up to 100 watt, and we can see the wattage on Super Tank Pro version. With the stock PD USB-C cable, I can get 100 watt. But with InCharge X, I couldn't get the charging speed to 100 watt. Maximum I could get was 60 watt, or similar to other cables that I have and rated 65 watt. So is the max version. and I reconfirmed with the stock PD USB-C cable again, and it was given 100 watt. Let me know down in the comments if any of you who has this managed to get the speed up to 100 watt. I hope that the company didn't mistakenly advertise 100 watt, but actually the cable is only capable for 65 watt. Next test is if you use any phones with USB-C port and has larger battery. You can use your phone as the power bank for other devices with micro USB or Lightning port. The other thing that I think it could be improved is the length of the standard version, which I think it is way too short for some use cases. Adding few centimeters wouldn't hurt portability of it, I think. But hey, that's why there's max version, right? Overall, apart from only 60 watt max based on my test and the length of the standard version, I can live with this little thing unless, of course, if I get any device which requires 100 watt. If anyone from Rolling Square see this, please do comment on the 100 watt spec. So what do you think about this little accessory? Let me know down in the comments. And if you like the video, please hit like, share to those who might be interested, and subscribe to the channel where I will make more of these type of reviews. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you won't miss any new videos. That's it for today, and I will see you next time. Have a safe and healthy day, y'all. Everyone needs it.